In 2010, the board of directors of Toastmasters International conducted a SWOT analysis. Sounds exciting, right? Strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, threats. Oh, I wish I was in that board meeting. As a result, though, of that board meeting, there were two clear things that came out of it that made them reassess the education system that Toastmasters is, as we currently know it, and is about to change. In fact, this change is already underway, and it's going to be changing in Western Australia in January. The two key things that came out of it was, first, that the current system is split into two paths. There is a leadership module, or the leadership track, and also a communication track. And they realised that leadership and communication are separate. They've been separate. Why on earth would we have two different tracks when really communication and leadership, it's all the same thing? The second thing that they realised as part of this was that the number of members that are actually achieving awards is far lower than they would like. For example, the percentage of people achieving a competent communicator award, and do you know much about Toastmasters yet, Leo?
Yeah,
you remember. Okay. The number of people that are achieving a competent communicator award is about 10% of all members. Those members that are achieving a competent leadership award, 2%. 2 in every 100. Any kind of advanced manual, only 1% of people are achieving any kind of advanced manual. As a result of this, they thought we need to simplify things such that members can be achieving awards quicker and therefore getting recognition for what they're doing, and as a result, feel more motivated to carry on within the Toastmasters system. As part of those two key learnings, they've totally changed the education system. The meetings as we know it will fundamentally stay the same, but the manuals that we're working from are going to change. In fact, 80% of what we'll be using won't be on the printed materials at all. It's all switching 21st century style online. And every one of us here will be given access to what they call a base camp. And from this base camp, you can then access all the materials that you need in order to do any of your projects. Now, the way it's split up as well has also changed. They're no longer going to have two separate tracks for leadership and for the communication. They're going to have 10 different paths which you can choose. And along these paths, the leadership and communication is going to be combined. How they're going to decide which path is right for which member, though, is largely a member choice. But they've put out there 5 core competences. And these core competences then dictate which of the paths the individual would like to, is going to be most suitable based on those core competences. For example, the core competences are public speaking, interpersonal communication, strategic leadership, management, and confidence. Now, each of those 10 different paths, and depending on the path that you choose, each of those paths has a different focus on those core competences. And so you will learn different skills depending on the path that you're choosing. The paths aren't simply focused on the core competences, though. They're also lined up with the direction that you want to be going in, depending on where you want to take Toastmasters outside of Toastmasters. For example, there's a dynamic leadership path. There's also a strategic relationships path, team collaboration, a presentation mastery. And depending on which path you choose, different core competences, and then a different focus outside of Toastmasters as well. So to give you an idea while I'm talking, I'll pass these around. The first page shows the 5 core competences on the left-hand side, the 10 paths on the right. Each of the next 10 pages shows each of the different paths and what projects are going to be inside. Don't worry about how it's all set up. I'll chat a bit about how it's going to work. Again, over the next few months, things will become much clearer. So you can just pass those around. Maybe just grab one of the paths and have a quick glance at the next one. So, within each path, how is it going to be structured? And what they've decided is because they want members to be achieving a wallet on a much quicker basis, they've split each of these paths up into 5 levels. And at the end of each level, you'll receive an award for that level. And at the end of completing a path, you'll also receive an award for achieving that path as well. If you are wanting to ultimately progress and become a distinguished Toastmaster, then in order to achieve that ultimate goal, you need to complete 2 paths in total, and then there's also a few things outside. For example, you need to have a year on a club committee, you need to carry out a speechcraft program, you need to work on the district for 12 months. There's 3 or 4 things like that in order outside of the paths which you need to do to become distinguished person. That's the fundamental structure. Within each path, as you will see on these pages, there are 14 projects. That's also part of that 5-level structure. Within each of those projects, there is at least 1 speech. But that doesn't mean that a project consists of only the speech. However, the first project of every path is always the icebreaker project. So the icebreaker appears in every one of those paths. And then all you've got to do for that first project is to deliver your icebreaker speech. However, for some of the other paths, some of the other projects, there are more complex things that you need to achieve to sign off that particular project, besides just simply doing the speech. For example, one of the projects you'll see somewhere is putting together a podcast, putting together a blog. Obviously, you're not just going to stand up here and start doing the podcast or blog, otherwise there just isn't time. So for some of these projects, to achieve the goals, there are things you need to do outside of the club meeting as well. In a similar style to those things that you need to do to achieve the leadership goals on the leadership path. But fundamentally, that is the structure and what needs to be achieved in order to get a distinguished Toastmaster award. Now, when is it coming to Perth, and how is it going to affect all of us? To my notes here for this bit. So within Basecamp, that's the online section, and on there you'll have access to the projects, what they're calling resources, and within resources there will be online videos and a whole range of any evaluations can be uploaded online as well. How that will work, I'm not sure exactly. But there'll be transcripts, tips, tools, and your assessments. Now, not everything is going to be online because some people prefer to work with the printed materials. And for those people, there are going to be a limited number of paths available for those people that want to work only with the printed materials. So that option is still going to be there. But come January next year, in 2018, this is when it is currently expected to be scheduled to be hitting District 17. So we've got a few months for that to get everyone clued up and the district on board with the idea. There are going to be pathways guides and pathways ambassadors to help roll this system out across the district. A pathways ambassador will be in charge of their 8 to 10 clubs. By in charge, I mean be responsible for the communication process between the chief ambassador and those particular clubs. They're on top of that, they're then pathways guide, which will be the direct person going out to the specific club and giving the presentations, working with the VPU to find out what specific issues that club has and to make sure the transition process is as smooth as possible. It's very much a rolled out process though, so they're not just putting it in District 17 and every other district at the same time. It's a 2-year rollout process across the world, and we're coming roughly halfway through. So they've already rolled it out pretty much across half the world by the time it comes to us. So hopefully as a result of that, a lot of the issues will be ironed out by the time it comes to us. Before we move on to Sam, I know we're out of time, but at the end of this, at the end of today's meeting, have a think about any questions you might have about pathways, and I'll just make a note of them, because I put my hand forward to be a pathways guide this year, and so I'll be one, hopefully, as long as I get accepted, one of those people that is helping us transition. So if you've got any questions, then I can pass those questions on and make sure they get sorted. Have a think, and then I'll come back to you at the end of the meeting. In the meantime, I'd like to pass back to our wonderful Toastmaster, Mr. Sam Walton.